آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. وقال عز وجل: فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. وقال عليه الصلاة والتسليم: من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم. رواه البخاري ومسلم رحمهم الله. صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم ربنا زدنا علما يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Respected and honorable sisters, respected listeners, I would like to greet you with the universal greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Once again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with the month of Ramadan Kareem. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we are reaping the rewards and benefits of this blessed month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne hame ye babarkat mahina naseeb kiya aur hum is babarkat mahine se Allah rabbul izzat ki taraf ke bar Allah rabbul izzat ki taraf se barkaton se hum fayda utha rahe. We would have noticed that before Ramadan Kareem came, it was difficult for us to pick up the Quran and recite maybe a page or two. But alhamdulillah, through the blessings, through the barakah, and the blessings, special mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Rabbul Izzah has created this desire in ourselves that we want to try and do the recitation of the Quran as much as we can, alhamdulillah. Ramzan Kareem se pehle, hamare liye Quran Pak ki tilawat karna, hame bojh mahsoos ho raha tha. لیکن اللہ رب العزت نے ہم پر فضل کیا، کرم کیا، احسان کیا، اس بابرکت مہینے کی برکتوں سے اللہ رب العزت نے ہم سب کے لیے تلاوت کلام پاک کو آسان کر دیا. This is a month in which at least one dua is accepted daily. Accepted daily from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from every Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me and you to ask from his treasures. Ye babarkat mahina aisa Allah rabbul izzat hamari har musalman ki rozani ki ek dua zarur qabul farmata. Ye qabooliyat e dua ka waqt hai. Ye mausam hai duaon ke qabool karwane ka. My Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was mentioned in a very beautiful hadith reported by Ubay ibn Samit radiyallahu ta'ala an. Hazrat Ubay ibn Samit radiyallahu ta'ala ek hadith riwayat karte hain. Hamare Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ne irshad farmaya, ataakum ramadan shahr barakatin yaghshakum Allah fi fayunazzilu ar-rahmata fi. Ramzan ka babarkat mahina aa chuka hai. The blessed month of Ramadan has come upon you. Month of blessings. Barakaton ka mahina. Yaghshakum Allahu fi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala turns towards you. And then he descends upon you. Fayunazzilu rahmata fi. His special mercies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tumhari taraf mutawajjih hote hain aur khususi tawajjuh Allah rabbul izzat hamari taraf inayat farmate hain aur Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala apni khususi rahmaton ko hum par nazil farmate hain. His choicest blessings and his barakah is coming down upon the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month of Ramadan. وَيَحُطُّ الْخَطَايَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives our sins. Allah gunaakum maaf farmate. وَيَسْتَجِيبُ فِيهِ الدُّعَا. Allah ta'ala usme dua ko qabool farmata. We need to beseech Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the depth of our hearts. Hame dil ke gehraiyon se, meri pyari maa aur behne aur mere muhtaram hazrat, hame dil ki gehraiyon se, Allah ke khazanon se, hame mangna hai Allah rabbul izzat apne khazanon ke dene se. Allah kabhi nahi kabhi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ke khazanon mein se koi cheez kami nahi hogi. Kami hai hamare mangne. There will be no deprivation from the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will be granted from the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we ask from the depth of our hearts, and if we ask attentively to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if we ask with the conviction, with the yaqeen that Allah rabbul izzah will accept my prayer, inshallah. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cannot say a word of lie. He says, yastajibu fi du'a, Allah accepts the prayer in this month. Allah isme duaen qabool farmata hai. Allah ke nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam kabhi jhoot to nahi bol sakte. So this is a month of asking from the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yastajibu fihi ad-du'a, yanzuru Allah ta'ala ila tanafusikum fihi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he appreciates, Allah rabbul izzat appreciates our competition with each other. Abdullah, Abdurrahman, Fatima, Zainab, oh my sister, Allah doesn't look at who's making the nice bajiyas and who's got the best kebabs and who's got the best, you know, chicken steaks and fish steaks and meat steaks and who's got the best dish on the dastarkhan for the day for the iftar. Allah is going to be looking upon mine and your competition with each other, that who is going to surpass each other in virtue and in righteousness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ye nahi dekhenge ki kiska dish acha hai, kiski biryani achhi hai, kiska murgha musallam acha hai, kiski botiya bahut lazeez hai, kiski lassi achhi hai, kiski biryani achhi hai, aur kiske kebab achhe hai, kiske samosa achhe hai, kiske spring roll achhe hai. Pata nahi kya kuch humne ramzan se pehle ramzan ke iftar ke liye kya na kuch tariyaya aur kitne ghante humne nikale hamare ramzan ki iftar ke waqt ke khane के लिए. लेकिन मेरी प्यारी माए बहने, अल्लाह ये नहीं देखेगा, हाँ उसका अजर जरूर मिलेगा. यू विल डेफिनेटली रिवॉर्डेड. यू हैव स्पेंट टाइम फ्रॉम योर प्रेशियस टाइम टू ट्राई एंड सर्व योर फैमिली, टू ट्राई एंड गिव द बेस्ट फूड ऑन द टेबल फॉर योर फैमिली. अल्लाह विल रिवॉर्ड यू फॉर दैट विदाउट द शैडो ऑफ अ डाउट. बट दैट इज नॉट व्हाट अल्लाह रब्बुल इज्जत इज आस्किंग फ्रॉम अस. ही इज आस्किंग फ्रॉम अस द बेस्ट ऑफ आवर डीड्स. उसका तो अजर मिलेगा, आपने जो कुर्बानियां की लेकिन वो मकसूद नहीं है। रमजान मुबारक का मकसूद लजीज खाना नहीं है, इफ्तार के वक्त अपने पेट को भरना सिर्फ नहीं है, बल्कि वो अल्लाह की नेमत है, हम उसका शुक्रिया अदा करें। اللهم لك صمت وبك آمنت وعلى رزقك أفطرت فتقبل مني ذهب الظمأ وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله। अगर ये दुआ करेंगे اللهم اغفر لي اللهم مني مغفر الفرما ذهب الظمأ प्यास चली गई وابتلت العروق और रगे पुर हो रगे तर हो गई وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله। और अल्लाह की यहां जो रोजे रखने का अजर है इन शाह अल्लाह वो साबित होगा इन शाह अल्लाह। Our quench will have gone. Our thirst has gone. ذهب الظمأ وابتلت العروق. And the veins and our arteries have been moistened. And then the ajr and the reward will definitely be established for us. We need these du'as. The du'a at the time of iftar is very important. Subhanallah, when we are preparing for the iftar, it should not be, my beloved brother and sister in Islam, that so many a times we're in the masjid and it's the time of iftar and 5 minutes before, we're more worried about where are my dates and where is my water. The sister in the kitchen should try and make sure she, you know, she has all the chores has been done and dusted with 10 minutes before. Come and sit on your dastarkhan. Engage in dua. Engage in worship. Engage turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because in the iftar, my Habib Sassim says, the dua which is made at the time of iftar is accepted. Allah. Ye dua kabhi rad nahi hogi. इफ्तारी से पहले जो तैयारी है जिस वक्त हम इफ्तार करते हैं उस वक्त ऐसा ना हो कि बातचीत में मुबतला हम मशगूल हो जाए। बिस्मिल्लाह व बरकतिल्लाह बिस्मिल्लाह व बरकतिल्लाह बिस्मिल्लाह से अपने रोजे को खोल ले और फिर रोजे को खोलने के बाद फिर दुआ करे اللهم اغفر لي يا واسع الفضل اغفر لي اے وسیع فضل والا میری مغفرت فرما او द ग्रेशियस वन او द वन हुज ग्रेस इज वास्ट अल्लाह प्लीज फॉरगिव मी। اللهم إنا نسألك برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء أن تغفر لي. You pray this dua. يا واسع الفضل اغفر لي. Or just say اللهم اغفر لي. اللهم لك صمت وبك آمنت وعلى رزقك أفطرت فتقبل مني. والله for you I have fasted. And upon you I have faith. And upon your sustenance I break my fast. وعليك توكلت and upon you يا الله I have full faith. وعليك توكلت and upon you الله I have full faith. فتقبل مني والله accept. والله accept. These are the du'as that we should be reading at the time when we, that is the time, most important time of ensuring that we ask Allah SWT. ये सबसे अहम घड़ी है दुआ मांगने की सबसे अहम घड़ी है। 10 मिनट 15 मिनट पहले माशाल्लाह हम दुआ के अंदर मशगूल होते हैं वो भी अच्छा है, लेकिन जिस वक्त हम इफ्तार करते हैं जब रोजा खोलते हैं उस वक्त बातों में मशगूल न होइए। उस वक्त जो है मेरी माए बहन किचन में अभी पकाने में और गर्म गर्म खाना देने में मशगूल न हो। मेरी प्यारी माए और बहने हमें उस वक्त दुआ में मशगूल होना चाहिए। ये इफ्तार का वक्त ये दुआ की कबूलियत का वक्त है। जैसे सुहूर के वक्त तहज्जुद का वक्त है। At the time of suhoor, we wake up a bit early and we pray our salatul tahajjud and we make dua because that time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making an announcement. Ala min mustaghfirin faghfir la. Is there anybody who is seeking for forgiveness who I can forgive? Koi hai maafi chahne wala jisko main maaf kar lu. Ala min mustaghfirin faghfir la. Ala min mubtalin fa'afiya. Koi hai musibat mein mubtala jisko main afiyat bakhshu. Is there anybody entrapped in some kind of a difficulty whom I can relieve? Ala min sa'ilin fa'utiya. Is there anybody who wants to ask from me who I can grant? Kya koi hai mangne wala jisko main ata karun? This is the time in the suhoor wa in the iftar. At the time of iftar, at the time of suhoor, we need to engage in dua and ask Allah with the conviction. Allah will accept it, inshallah. Tawajjuh ke saath, betawajjuh ke saath dua na mange. Isliye ke do dua betawajjuh se mari jayegi. Allah Rabbul Izzat ki taraf se qabooliyat ke vaada nahi hai. We have to make sure that we are attentive. We are not neglectful towards our dua. So this is a month. Rasulullah says, يَنْبُرُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِلَىٰ تَنَافُسِكُمْ فِيهِ. Allah looks at our competition. Allah ہمارا آپس کے مقابلے کو دیکھتا ہے. کون کتنی زیادہ عبادت میں آگے ہے. اللہ اکبر کبیرہ. میرے حبیب صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم فرماتے ہیں, وَيُبَاهِ بِكُمْ مَلَائِكَتَا. اور اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی تمہارے آپس میں تمہاری عبادت کے ایک دوسرے کے ساتھ مسابقت کو دیکھ کر اللہ تعالی فرشتوں کے سامنے فخر کرتا ہے. اللہ اکبر. اللہ تعالی boasts to the angels, look at my slaves. Look at my slaves. Look at my ibadullah. Look at my ima'ullah. Look at my male slaves. Look at my female servants. Look at my male servants. Look at my female servants. That they are engaged. They have all kind of base desires. They have carnal desires. They have given everything up for my pleasure. And they are fasting for my pleasure. And today, I am going to grant them their needs, inshallah. He feels I'm proud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he boasts about us. In front of the malaika. Allah malaika ke samne fakhr karte hai. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jo hai na farishton ke samne fakhr ka fakhr ke taur pe bayan farmate hai ke dekho mere bande inke sath har khwahish lagi hui hai lekin uske baad yad'u ta'amahu wa sharabahu li ajli. Isne apna khana apna peena meri wajah se chhod rakha hai, meri raza ke liye chhod rakha hai, main usko zarur ata karu. السوم لی, روزہ رکھنا وہ میرے لیے, وہ انا اجزی بھی اور میں ہی خود اس کا بدلہ دوں گا. The first thing is for me and I will reward. And another riwaya, some ulama have said, وہ انا اجزا بھی, I will become the reward for that person. Allah Akbar. So alhamdulillah, this is a month where we do one deed. ایک نیکی کا عمل, ایک نیکی کا عمل. من تقرب الي بخصله من الخير كان كمن ادى فريضه فيما سوى ومن ادى فريضه فيه كان كمن ادى 70 فريضه فيما سوى. If we do one righteous deed, it will be as though we have done a fard, a compulsory act. اور اگر ایک فرض ادا کریں گے تو اللہ 70 گنا ہمیں اس کا ثواب دے گا. One fard, we read our two rakats of salatul fajr, Allah will give us as though 70 times reading Salat al-Fajr, subhanAllah. These are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choicest moments, choicest blessings for the Ummah at large. And this month, inshallah, in the days and weeks to come, we know we are going through, the first ashara is coming to an end. Pehla ashara apni ikhtitam ko pahunch raha hai. The awwaluhu rahma, first 10 days were the days of mercy. Wa awsatuhu maghfira, the middle 10 days are going to be the days of the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa awsatuhu maghfira, wa akhiruhu itqum minan nar. And the last 10 days will be freedom from the hellfire, from emancipation from the hellfire. Awwal dasdin, Allah کی رحمت کے ہیں, مردمیان کی مغفرت اور آخر کے جہنم سے چھٹکاری. اللہ تعالی ہم سب کو جہنم کا چھٹکارہ نصیب فرمائے. آمین یا رب العالمین. And within these last 10 days, we're going to have the night of power, Laylatul Qadr, night of value. And inshallah, we will talk about that on a later day, inshallah. One worship in the night of power is greater than 1,000 months. Ek ghari ibadat karna Laylatul Qadr mein hazar mahino se behtar hai, subhanallah. اس مہینے میں ہم دیکھو ہمارے دسترخوان میں اللہ تعالیٰ وسیع فرما دیتا ہے. شارن تزار فی رزق المؤمن, اس میں مومن کی روزی کو بڑھا دیا جاتا ہے. The provision of the believer is increased. اللہ خوب برکت نصیب کرتا ہے, سبحان اللہ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the month where the angels, malaika khud, ہمارے لیے اللہ سے معافی طلب کرتے ہیں. This is a month in which the angels seek forgiveness for the fasting servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the angels send mercy upon those who partake of suhoor. یہ بھی بہت اہم ہے. We have to ensure that we are also we take time out and we perform sahri. As-suhoor sunnah. Tasahharu, do suhoor. Many a times we know many a people that they say, oh, at night I'll have something to eat and I'll just have a sip of water. Even if you have to wake up for that 10 minutes, obviously, like I said, it's a very important time. We should wake up and pray tahajjud, and then we should, if you don't have anything to eat, have a sip of water, have one date. نعم السهور التمور أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم, the best form of sahri is to have dates, subhanAllah. the best form. Try it. You'll see, inshallah. You have dates, and inshallah, with dates, maybe you can have some porridge or some seed or something like that. But generally, if we eat other stuff, then, you know, we can have indigestion problem, we can have gas problems. What kuch aur ghizaein hame khane ki aadat hi hoti hai. Lekin ye asal cheez agar khayenge, to pet mein bhi rahat rahegi, inshallah. Aur roza bhi bade aasani aur sahulat se, inshallah, ikhtitam ko pahunchega, inshallah. So this is a month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sahri ka waqt bada barkat ka waqt hai, sahri sunnat hai, sahri sunnah, we should try and make up a suhoor and partake in suhoor because Allah Rabbul Izzah's special forgiveness and mercy comes down at that time. Subhanallah, la ilaha illallah. Those who partake in suhoor, the angels and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they send mercy upon the people. Mercy is showered during all these special times, subhanallah. It is the month. In this month, we know, we've heard from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let me finish the hadith which I started. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks upon your competition and he boasts about your worship and your commitment to your Lord. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فَأَوْلَّهَ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ خَيْرًا. So show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of your deeds. Allah ko batlao, tumhari a'mal mein sabse behtareen amal. يسيني بن حبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم فرمايا من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ضمي. Whosoever will spend the night in prayer, stand up in prayer with full faith and conviction, with full faith and conviction, and having and also with the إيمانا واحتسابا, also seeking reward. Also seeking reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless that person, not having any kind of ostentation, riya ke bagair, Allah par iman rakhte hue, sawab ki umeed rakhte hue, in search of recompense from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, Rasulullah says, ghufir lahu, for him, all of his sins will be forgiven, subhanallah. Uske tamam guna maaf kar diye jayenge. All of their sins will be forgiven, inshallah. One who fasts again with full faith, with full conviction in Allah, in his Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in the books, everything, in Sharia, he has full faith in the Sharia, and he is seeking reward from Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Or wo sawab ki umeed rakhte hue roze rakhta hai, to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala uske pichle guna maaf kar dete hain. Allah Taala forgives their past sins. Subhanallah. This person's sins are forgiven. Subhanallah. In this month, we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala futihat abwaabul jannah, the doors of jannah are flung open. Jannat ke darwaze khol diye jate hai, wa ghulqat abwaabul nar, and the doors of jahannam are locked. Or jahannam ke darwaze band kar diye jate hai, jahannam ki darwaze band kar diye jate hai, wa suffilat shayateen, aur ye wo mahina hai jisme shaitan ko jakra jata hai. This is the month in which the shaitan is shackled. He doesn't have inflows upon us. Allah makes it easy, like I said earlier, Allah makes it easy for us to acquire Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it difficult for us to take and tread the path of Jahannam. Subhanallah. La ilaha illallah. Say la ilaha illallah. Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Eh mahina hai. Jiske andar Allah ta'ala hamare jannat ka raasta aasan kar deta hai. Aur Jahannam ke raaste ko Allah Rabbul Izzat hamare liye mushkil kar deta hai. Matlab ye ki hum jannat wale raaste pe chalenge. Jahannam wale raaste se Allah ta'ala hame bachayega. Subhanallah. During this auspicious month, we are expected to fast and keep control of our base desire. ये वो बाबरकत महीना है जिसमें हमें रोजा रखने और रोजे रखने का मकसद क्या? हम तक्वा हासिल करें, हमारी नफसानी ख्वाहिशात पर कंट्रोल रखें. And we acquire taqwa. Taqwa has been mentioned many a times in the Quran. Allah ने taqwa बहुत सी जगहों पर इशारा फरमाया. मतलब ये कि we have the conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have the thought in our heart and mind. Allah Rabbul Izzah is looking upon me. हमारे दिलों दिमाग में हो, Allah Rabbul Izzah मुझे देख रहा है. इसी का नाम तक्वा है. La wala kal kat ek riwayat mein aata hai mere habib sallallahu alaihi wasallam farmaya koi parhezgari nahi hai gunahon se bachne ki tarah se taqwa ka naam gunahon se bachna hai abstinence from sins is vital in the holy month of ramadan we have to abstain from sins abstain from sins we have to make this resolve to spend the entire month of ramadan without committing a single sin and resolve to continue the same after ramadan inshallah hum pukhta irada kar rahe hum gunahon ko apne gunahon se apne aap ko bachayenge gunah se bachna ye bahut aham hai hazrat abdullah ibn abbas radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu a great sahabi of rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam he was asked the question somebody came sa'alahu rajul iman came and asked the question he says rajulun iman kathirul dhunub a'jab ilayka aw rajulun qalilul amal qalilul dhunub he asks a very important question he says a man a person who does a lot of sins and a lot of actions bahut tasbih padhna bahut quran pak ki tilawat karna bahut ibadat karna ek wo hai jo bahut ibadat karta lekin saath saath mein gunah bhi bahut kar raha hai a person is committing a lot of sins yet they're doing a lot of actions as well a lot of deeds as well so is this person ajab ilayk kya wo tumhe zyada pasand hai tumhe zyada behtar lagta hai aao ya wo aadmi rajul ke jo qalilul amal qalilud dhunub ke jo kam amal karne wala ho lekin uske gunah bhi kam ho kam amal karta hai lekin gunah kam karta hai oh that person is better for you is more valuable in your sight who is doing less yet he is abstaining from sins he is doing very less sins the purpose of fasting ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam kama kutiba alal ladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun iman walo allah kitne pyare andaaz se hame keh raha ya ayyuhalladhina amanu iman walo tum par roze farz kar diye gaye hain jaise tumse pehle logon par roze farz kar diye gaye the kyunki ताकि तुम तक्वा हासिल करो ताकि तुम मुत्तकी बन जाओ ओ यू पीपल हु बिलीव fast have been ordained upon you they have been prescribed upon you like they were ordained and prescribed upon the people before you why la'allakum tattaqun so that you may become god conscious taqwa Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas says, a person is doing a lot of worship, yet he's committing a lot of sins. He's backbiting, he's slandering, he's not taking care of his eyesight, his tongue is saying, lying, swearing, whatnot and the other. He's doing a lot of sins. Yet he's doing a lot of tasbih, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, Durud Sharif, Quran Pak. Is that person better? Or person who does less? But it's not of what I would say. We need to do amal, which is of quality rather than quantity, subhanAllah. We don't look at the quantity. We look at the quality of the amal that we've done. Hame, hamare amal ki, jo hai na wo, ki tadad ko nahi dekhna chahiye. Uski kamiyat ko nahi dekhna chahiye, balki uski kaifiyat ko dekhna chahiye. Subhanallah. This sentence never come into my mind before. Ishpuri Baraka. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not looking upon the quantity of amal that you do. He's looking upon the quality of amal that you do. Allah wants us to have quality worship. That worship which is quality in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is going to be beneficial for me and you, inshallah ta'ala. Quality worship. Aisi ibadat kare. फरमाया कि जो कम इबादत करता है लेकिन कम गुनाह करता है हजरत अब्दुल्लाह इब्ने अब्बास फरमाया ला अदिलु बिस्सलामा व्हाट डज ही से व्हिच वन इज बेटर द वन हु डज लॉट ऑफ वर्शिप लॉट ऑफ सिंस और द वन हु डज लेस वर्शिप लेस सिंस ही सेज ला अदिलु बिस्सलामा आई डू नॉट थिंक एनीथिंग इक्वल टू स्टेइंग अवे फ्रॉम सिंस मैं गुनाहों से बचने के बराबर किसी चीज को बराबर नहीं समझता मतलब ये है कि गुनाह से बचना सबसे अहम चीज है मेरी प्यारी माए और बहने. So this is the month we need to make. The first thing we need to do is we need to make this firm resolution that we are going to abstain from sins. And then we don't waste any moment of our lives. We don't waste any moment of this Ramadan. Don't waste koi bhi ghari. Hum zaya na kare. We should make a timetable. Timetable banao. Ke bhai hamara abhi dekho 10 din to guzar gaye. Abhi 20 din baki hai. Uske liye bhai subah ke waqt ye kaam karna hai. Dupair ke agar koi timetable or schedule nahi hoga, to tumhara waqt kahin par mutlaq khatam ho jaye. There has to be a schedule. There has to be a timetable. Our mashayikh, our buzurugs have encouraged us to have a timetable. Set out times for daily worships and practices. Take time out for the tilawat of the Quran. Take time out for dua. And then you do it according to that, inshallah. Quran and dhikr. Quran ke liye, dhikr ke liye. Waqt mukhtas kar lo. Ki ye waj aaram ka waqt hai. Iske baad uthne ka waqt hai. Phir mujhe ye namaz parni hai. Phir mujhe ye karna hai. Phir mujhe tilawat ikram akpa karni hai. Phir mujhe zikr karna hai. Phir mujhe dua karni hai. Ek time da dimaag mein thoda set hona chahiye. Set hona chahiye. And the last but not least, most importantly, we need to reflect on our past lives. Sabse aham, hamein hamari pichli zindagi par ek nazar daurani. Iska muhasaba karna, uska hisab muhasaba. We need to take accountability. We need to take accountability of our past. Contemplate of what we should be doing. We need to reflect upon our lives and we need to make a strong and firm resolution that what we are going to do, how we're going to make progress in our future lives, Islamically, religiously, and also maybe in our worldly aspects as well. Hame ye azmi musammam karna hai, pukhta irada karna hai. कि मैं आगे मेरी रूहानियत को पुख्तगी के लिए मैं क्या करें, दुनिया की भलाइयां कैसे मुझे हासिल हो, आखिरत की भलाइयां मुझे कैसे हासिल हो. दुनिया की भलाइयां मांगने में कोई हर्ज नहीं. There is no harm asking for worldly goods. Allah says Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Oh Allah Ta'ala, grant us the goodnesses of this world and grant us the goodnesses of the akhirah. We need to repent of our past. पिछले गुनाहों से तोबा. अत्ताइबु मिनज़्ज़म्बे कमल्ला ज़म्बला. पिछले गुनाहों से तोबा करेंगे, हमारा कोई गुनाह बाकी नहीं रहेगा. रिपेंटिंग फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ आवर पास्ट सिन. नाउ वी नीड टू अडॉप्ट गुड डीड्स थ्रू दिस ब्लेस्ड मंथ ऑफ रमजान. वी शुड फर्मली रिजॉल्व टू कंटिन्यू इंप्रूविंग आवर रिलेशनशिप विद आवर क्रिएटर सो दैट इन दिस मंथ our bond with our creator becomes strong and then we further that and we continue with that in the 11 months that come after Ramadan Kareem. Is babar ke mahine mein apne Allah se apne Rab se rishte ko mazboot kar le taaki aainda aane wale 11 mahine hamare liye aasan ho jaye. So therefore, in conclusion for today, let us make the most of our Ramadan. Let us make the most of this Ramadan through this sacrifice, through mujahada. Mujahada means self-sacrifice. Try and give up our luxuries. Try and give up our leisures. Apne jo hai na qurbani de, qurbani dekar, roze rakhkar, tarawih parkar, aur ibadat karke, and we do this worship and doing the ibadah of the level of quality, the quality of taqwa, and try to do something by developing taqwa in our a'mal, and inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enlighten our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hamare dilon ko noor se bhar denge, hamare dilon ko munawwar kar denge, inshallah jo hai agar hamare dil munawwar ho jayenge, if our hearts are enlightened by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this will in turn make us have it will take out the filth of the sin. It will take out the filth of the sin. Gunaw ki jo palidgi hai, wo inshallah hamare dilon se nikal jayegi. It will be a means of shunning the filth of the sins in our hearts. And then we will start to begin to despise. Aur phir hame gunahon se nafrat hone lagegi. Phir hame gunahon se nafrat hone lagegi. Agar ye inshallah humne hasil kar liya, to samajh le meri pyari maa aur behne aur mere muhtaram hazrat ki hamara ramzan kamyab ho gaya. Hamara ramzan alhamdulillah bahut khair aur afiyat se guzra. Despite having witnessed the many, many Ramadans have passed before, and despite we have witnessed the blessings of many months of Ramadan in our lives, Let's make this Ramadan a special Ramadan, and let us make this intention that we're going to make this Ramadan a changing Ramadan, inshallah. Hum ye irada kar le ki is Ramadan ko inshallah hum jo hain wo apni zindagi mein tabdili layenge, apni zindagi mein hum tabdili layenge, aur ye tabdili inshallah is Ramadan mein hum apni zindagi ke dus inshallah ye turning point hoga, meri zindagi ke Allah ki taraf palatne ka mauka hoga, Allah ki taraf qurb ka mauka hoga, taqarrub ka mauka hoga inshallah, because there is no guarantee who will be living until the next Ramadan. Koi bharosa nahi aainda Ramadan tak kiski zindagi baki hai. We don't know. So many people have come and so many people have gone. I just like to mention at this juncture that many have lost many of their loved ones in the past year or so, in the very recent past. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of them sabr, those who have lost their loved ones and dear ones, whether it's through the pandemic of the coronavirus, whether it's through some kind of an incident, or whether it was natural causes, or however they have lost their loved and beloved ones. Remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahu Akbar, mere Habib sallallahu alaihi wasallam par kya kuch halat nahi aaye, mere Habib sallallahu alaihi wasallam par kya kuch halat, hame isse sabak hasil karna chahiye, hame isse sabak hasil karna chahiye. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki paidaish se pehle Allah ke Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke walid muhtaram ka intiqal ho jata hai. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's father passes away before he is even born. He is born an orphan. Fir uske baad bachpane mein Allah ke Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki maa ka intiqal ho jata hai, aur in the childhood mother passes away, and then comes along Rasulullah his grandfather passes away, fir unke jo hai na unke dada ka intiqal ho jata hai. Then comes along, he goes further, and then Allahu Akbar, he goes through so many phases, and time comes when he has children, so many of his children. Allah ke Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke kitne bacche unke hayat mein, Allah ke Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki betiyan aapki zindagi mein sab wafat payi. Aapne khud unke janaze ko dekhe siway Hazrat Fatima radhi Allahu ta'ala anha ke jo aap sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke intiqal ke 6 mahine baad wo bhi Allah ta'ala ko pyari ho gayi hai. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam buried his own children with his own hands. He saw the death of his wife Hazrat Khadija radhi Allahu ta'ala anha. He saw the death of his children. He saw the death of his beloved uncle Abu Talib as well. He saw the death of many of his close ones. We need to take a lesson. We need to get inspired by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If Allah takes away any of our loved ones, then we need to remember, we should not despair. We should not be saying things which are not appropriate. We should have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. For Allah, to Allah we belong, and to Allah we will return. Remember, Allah has given us life for short moments, and this life is an amana, is a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If any of our loved one goes, then we need to make sure we prepare for our life as well. In conclusion, my beloved sisters in Islam, alhamdulillah, this is the month we need to take the most advantage of. We need to try and make sure we make the best of this holy month of Ramadan. And in this month, I just like to leave you with a special amal, a special action of this holy month. There is 4 things we need to do constantly, regularly. We need to read this dua. I'd like to leave you with this dua. La ilaha illallah. نستغفر الله ونسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار. یہ 4 خصوصی طور پہ ہمیں ذکر اس بابرکت مہینے میں کرنے ہیں. اللہ کے نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ہمیں اس ذکر کرنے کی ترغیب دی کہ شہادت کو بار بار خوب پڑھو, اس کو کثرت سے کرو, اور اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی پر یقین کے جو ہے نا کلمہ کو بار بار دہراؤ, استغفار کرو, اور اللہ سے جنت مانگو, جہنم سے پناہ مانگو. لا الہ الا اللہ, اس سے کلمہ شہادت آ گیا. لا الہ الا اللہ has included, comes the abundance of reciting of the La ilaha illallah. Afdalu dhikri La ilaha illallah. The best form of dhikr is La ilaha illallah. So ye bhi aagaya. La ilaha illallah. Nastaghfirullah. Then we seek istighfar and forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala se maafi mange, aur maafi mange, aur fir Allah ta'ala se hum jannat ki talab ho. Wa nas'alullahu jannah. Wa nas'aluka al-jannah. Wa na'udhu bika min an-nar. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for jannah, and we ask him from the protection of the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability to act upon what has been said. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to truly value Ramadan. Truly value Ramadan. This time round, Allah ta'ala make it a beginning of a new chapter in our lives. Make it a beginning of a new chapter in our lives, in which we gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and we become the true muttaqeen, or because we become as Allah Rabbul Izzah wishes us to be. Ameen ya Rabbul Alameen. Hum Allah se dua karte hain, Allah Taala hame is mahine ki qadar ki taufeeq naseeb farmaye, Allah Taala hamari zindagi ka naya chapter aur naya jo hai na Allah Subhanahu wa Taala naya baab Allah Taala khole, aur is baab ke zariye se hum Allah hum nayi zindagi aur ki shuruaat kare, Allah ke sukoon ki taraf hum barhe, Allah ki narazgi se apne aap ko bachaye, aur ye wo mahina ho jisme Allah Taala ki khushnudi ko hasil kare, aur hum khaas khususi taur par is babarakat mahine mein Allah Subhanahu wa Taala ke khususi bandon mein Allah Taala hame shamil farmaye, Allah Taala hame muttaqin mein shamil farmaye. Ameen ya rabbal alamin. Wa ma alaina illa al balagh, wa sallallahu ala al nabiyil kareem. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanak allahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wa sallallahu ala al nabiyil kareem. La ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika la, lahul mulku wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayt wa la mu'tiya lima manat, ولا ينفوض الجد منك الجد. يا رب صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. اللهم صل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كلما ذكره الذاكرون، وصل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كلما غفر ذكره الغافلون. اللهم ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا، ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا، ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به، واعف عنا واغفر لنا ورحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله، ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله، ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاد منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ، ولا حول لنا ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا، اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار، يا عزيز يا غفار يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ربنا تقبل منا صيام رمضان، اللهم تقبل منا قيام رمضان، اللهم تقبل منا تلاوة القرآن، وتجاوز عنا من خطأ ونسيان، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعلنا من المتقين، اللهم اجعلنا من المتقين، اللهم آت أنفسنا تقواها وزكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم برحمتك يا رسول الله تعالى آخر سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Just one thing before I finish, I'd like to mention that, as you all know, Alhamdulillah, last year, mashallah, we did a very good fundraising for our Muslim Youth Center. Alhamdulillah, mashallah, sister donated towards the PA system, one sister donated towards the security system, and mashallah, about £55,000, mashallah, has been sent on the NYC. We have just got £5,000 left, Qarz Hasana. हमारे पास सिर्फ 5,000 पाउंड कर्ज हसना बाकी है, और सेंटर के बाहर जो ग्राउंड्स है उसको थोड़ा और जो उसके रिफर्बिश करना है, वी नीड टू डू सम रिफर्बिशमेंट वर्क्स फॉर इन द ऑन द एक्सटर्नल ऑफ आवर मदरसा इंशाल्लाह. सो वी आर मेकिंग अ हंबल रिक्वेस्ट टुडे, रिमेंबर मा नक़सत मालुम मिन सदका, इफ यू गिव सदका अल्लाह विल नेवर डिक्रीज. Charity never decreases wealth. Allahu Akbar. My Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Wa ma anfaqtum min khayr fa huwa yukhlifu." Whatever you spend from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will replace that. Jo bhi tum kharch karoge, Allah ta'ala uska badla dega. Allah will recompensate that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uska badla ata farmayenge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely replace that for us. Whatever we give in the path of Allah will never be wasted. My humble request to all my listeners, to the parents of also our children that come to the Muslim Youth Center, to the sisters that attend the Muslim Youth Center, women's classes, and all the other people that are listening. We only have £10,000 request for this Ramadan. Let's make Muslim Youth Center debt-free. Let's make Muslim Youth Center debt-free by making sure we donate lillah donations. Sadaqa, la badiru bi sadaqa, fa innal bala'a la yataqatta'a. Give optional charity. For optional charity, will never make a calamity come upon you. A sadqa karne mein, jaldi karo. Isliye ke sadqa karne se koi musibat tumhare par aa nahi sakti. Wo musibat ko taal deti hai. Badiru bi sadaqa, fa innal bala'a la yataqatta'a. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, innama sadaqa la tutfi'u ghadab ar-rab. Sadqa, optional charity. Giving lillah for the sake of Allah will give us a good death, will save us from a bad death, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save us from his anger. Allah hame gusse se bachayega, aur Allah ta'ala hame buri maut se bachayega. So my beloved sisters and beloved brothers in Islam, I'd like to make a humble appeal on behalf of Muslim Youth Center that please, here this year, we only have an appeal of £10,000, and inshallah, we have got 20 days. If we can raise maybe inshallah, maybe 1,000 a day, so by the last ashara, inshallah, we will be done and dusted, inshallah. Oh, inshallah, if we can raise £500 a day by the end of Ramadan, inshallah, £10,000 will be raised for the sake of Muslim Youth Center, who will be able to give our remaining £5,000 debt to Qarz-e Hasana 5,000 baki, wo bhi hum ada kar sakte hain, aur 5,000 jo bahar ke kaam ke liye hum aapse appeal kar rahe hain, usme bhi aap inshallah hissa dal sakte hain. I will be sharing a text with you. Please try and share that with your family and friends as well. Share it and inshallah donate towards the account of MYC. You can call me on 07743889163 if you want to give cash donations. You can also contact Naseema Apa or Sajid Apa, or you can contact me and I can direct you to the numbers of our respected Apas as well. But please donate with an open heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you for your donation in this best month. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.